Hello, everybody. Welcome back to this DCS liberation campaign. So we are on mission number 23. Wow, what an accomplishment. 23 missions. So last time, a little bit of strategy for you all. Last time we were able to take Mineral and Bodhi and Sochi. So a lot of success. That means we were up to $954 million dollars per turn. As you can see, I've already used a lot of that money. Most of it was beefing up the air defenses around Sochi here, because once it's ready to go, we're going to be moving a lot of our flights up there. So yeah, I put in Avenger. I have a Hawk system. I put in a AIM-9, or sorry, AIM-120 system, and then here I put in a Patriot. So a lot of air defenses in this area. So hopefully this will be our kind of a backstop for any kind of flights coming in. As you can see, I'm moving up both the carrier group and the Tarawa group, moving them up a little bit, put them a little bit in harm's way because we are moving them closer to these ships. So that's why my mission today is to do an anti-ship mission. So I'll be part of a package. I'm going to just do my single flight, and then I have five more F-18s that will be kind of in the same time slot. I also have some more F-18s flying out of is it Sukumi here? Yeah, Sukumi, to take it out at the same time. So I try to do the timing all at the same time, so we all launch our harpoons at the same time to saturate the air with those harpoons. So that is our mission today. For the other missions, we have our Western Front and our Eastern Front. I am moving a lot of frontline units, or units that I purchased last round, up to Mineral and Vodi, so it can beef up the army up there. Now for Sochi, they are a little too close up here, so I'm actually putting them in retreat mode to pull them back a little bit and keep them safer in this area. That way we don't have to send in a lot of CAS flights where they might be in harm's way here with the ships and also the SA-11 and this remaining SA-10. So in addition to the anti-ship strike, we have a couple of these airports. The Mykop, sorry, and Krasnodar have pretty significant jets at them, including the Su-30s and 15 MiG-31s at the Mykop. And then at Krasnodar, they have a whole bunch of MiG-31s as well. So I am anticipating a lot of MiG-31s and those Su-30s patrolling this area. And so we need to put in a lot of cap in this area. So I have a lot of cap flights to protect the frontline units and this area, as well as my flight as well. I have some F-15s coming out. Hopefully they can provide a little bit of cap support in this area before we get there, because I do anticipate a lot of MiG-31s and those SU-30s flying out. So that is today's mission. By the way, this is the second time I've recorded this. I forgot to select the smart screen on the game recording last time. So yeah, n take number two. So let's go ahead and jump in the Hornet. We're going to be on the deck today in another night mission, and I'm going to turn up my gamma a little bit and to see if we can try to help with that darkness. And also, I think future missions or future campaigns that should I do, I'll try to limit the an amount of night missions. I think it's because I set this for fall time, and also which gives kind of equal weight to both night and day missions. So I do watch my videos, and I'm okay watching the night missions, but they're probably not that entertaining. Okay, enough of that. Let's jump in the game, and I'll see you on the deck. All right, see you in a sec. All right, welcome back. We're on the deck. This is our plane tonight. Sporting four harpoons. Looks like the rest of the flights will get spawned here shortly. I'm just gonna jump in while these F-18 or these F-14s take off. Any And yes, I did turn up my gamma, so it's a lot lighter here at nighttime. Honestly, see, I don't even need a flashlight. Pretty badass. All right, let's get this thing kicked on. APU. Flashlight's really bright now, huh? Alright, that's 22%. And those other flights should spawn in any time here.
Roll left. Flight controls.
Nice. Alright, and there's our recovery. Tanker, I have 3 tankers up. These are long missions for all of us in the Santai ship. So I have 3 tankers up to support all the F-18s. I don't want them running out of fuel. Okay, what do we got? Wasn't paying attention here. Oh yeah, let's start left engine. Up. Reset flight control. O-box. RDOVR way down. On carrier, on the hook bypass. Ante skid is off. That is good. And what do we got for bingo? And 7,000 pounds makes sense for how long we're traveling. And we're also at what, 3003. And 3003, very good. No bleed air. Just gonna do the start heading. Little sonic boom. Let's go get our data link up. Up. Tech in. We're going to be on 32 X-ray. And ICLS was channel 2. And we won't turn it on just yet. F is on. Okay. waypoint 7 is our bullseye. I don't know why I put it in, nobody ever calls it. And we'll do our countermeasures up in the air today. Alright, alignment is good. PINS, good. In flight. Alright, so let's check our weight. 46,000 pounds, so we need to go 17 on the stabilizers. So we'll go half flaps. Take off trim, and let's go 17 on the stabilizers. Very good. Alright, with that, this bird is ready to go. Set that to 50 feet.
Chief, remove the wheel chocks.
Copy. Wheel chocks are now removed.
Yeah, that gamma sure makes a difference, huh? I still don't get to see the pretty scenery, but that's all right. All right, this bird's ready. Trim's all set. And there's the other flights. Let's get out of their way. And we'll go to Cat 2 here. I gotta show my buddy. He asked for it to. What are they doing? Alright, so he's on the floor. Alright. Got my launch bar on the shuttle. Bar, so let's retract the launch bar. And this guy takes over and says, rev up those engines, baby. Back to controls. And let's loop.
Passing 2.5 kilo.
387, clear to switch.
387, switch to count two. The damn himself really high. Program up our countermeasures. So program one, I'll usually just do shaft. So we've got a push time at 4:20 a.m. local time, so we are 7.5 minutes away. Looks like those other flights are taking off. Excellent.
Overlord 1-1, airborne.
It's got 1-2-4. I think those F-15s are always on 1-2-4. Since I don't have a flight today. Yep. That gamma's up high. Purple's coming from.
Forward 1, passing waypoint 1 at 14,000.
Yep.
Forward 1, on station at Bulls 148 for 160 at 14,000.
Yep, let's see 15s. So 15 F-18s are taking off right now, so that's good.
Engine 1, airborne.
Alright, 2 minutes until we push to waypoint 2. A lot of friendly units up. I mean, need the flow lights. Alright, 1 minute and 7 seconds. That should work out pretty good. So it's push time, but none of the other flights are pushing yet. Actually, it's 41 after, so 41 seconds after, so not yet.
Infield 1, passing waypoint 1 at 30,000.
That's our tanker.
Infield 1, on station at Bulls 099 for 110 at 30,000. Passing waypoint 2 at 26,000. Colt 1, on station at Bullseye 147 for 90 at 26,000.
Let's just set up the flight for all these to be low. These are booms.
Airborne.
Alright, looks like all those flights are pushing. These guys are trailing a little bit. Waypoint 2 at 30 after. A little behind, but I'm speeding up. I'm liking this grouping right here. We're all gonna meet at waypoint 2 at the same time. Lots of harpoons in the air. It's forthcoming. I believe that guy right there is our tanker. Nobody's running out of fuel today.
Zodiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 016, 4-100, at 9000, hot. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 335, 4-160, at 35000, hot.
Some big 31s off for 2 o'clock. I doubt the flare is going to be any help, but let's see. So much for my cap support, there's way back here. Oh well.
Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 025, 480, at 25,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 026, 480, at 25,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 338, 4-130, at 35,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 027, 480, at 25,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 028, 480, at 25,000 knots.
Let's change the mode on all these.
At 25,000 knots.
Yeah, too many clouds. It's alright. We'll use the radar. Let's pick that first guy there.
Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 040470 at 25,000 knots.
Alright, we are in range. Actually, let's check the
Pontiac
safe page.
Overlord 1-1, Bra,
yeah, they're turning around.
041470 at 25,000 knots.
Alright, Alpha launched.
Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 027440 at 28,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 028440 at 28,000 knots. Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 044470.
These guys are close.
Pontiac 1-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 045-4790-25,098-29,000.
Alright, they've gone cold. Take a long shot here. Fox 3. Alright, we are Pitbull. Let's turn cold. Ship's not happy. The T2 is the ship.
Zero.
guy doing? Tin's not happy. How are we doing on fuel? 7,600 pounds. I think we got the ship. She's still up. Holy moly. Yeah, maybe we'll take off COM 1 now. What's this guy doing? Germans 100 miles away. Aight. Yeah, look at all these guys. I think they're all fueling up. Good. Some F-16s. Here. Oh yeah, F-15's got lots of fuel. Looks like they're hooking up, getting a little fuel. Very nice. Lots of fuel today. That was your gratuitous flyby for the night.
Abort inbound, resuming mission.
Dang it. Hit the wrong button there. Yeah, as I was screwing around with the scratch pad, I hit a button here that I no longer can. Sorry about that, folks.
Marshall 387. Marking mops 328450. Angels 24.5. State 6.3.
So we're on a 31 radial, which will set up a cruise on 031. 031. And we're going to be on 24 DME. And weight is good. 2, timing 24, gauge is 9. Yeah, the lights look weird with that gamma so high.
That's alright. It's alright.
Looks like we got some F-14s recovering. Alright, so I established Angels 9. I'm just going to get to 24 DME, and then I'll tell them I've established. Let's get out.
387, established Angels 9, state 5.6.
At the 5 minute mark, so I need 7 minutes. Yeah, we got good bad timing right now. So usually I have a 5 minute track. So I'm gonna have to shorten up that second one or extend this one out. Alright, so let's go through the checklist real quick. Got my hook down, yep, flaps will be set later, but extended skid is on carrier, range skid is on off, and hook bypass is on carrier. Spencer is off, good, and jammer's off, and I've turned off the RWR. Checking out to the 58 minute, I'm extending out. Hornet still commence time. 12 miles.
Might be early. It's alright, I think they'll live.
I see the tanker right there. Looks like they need to land. Half. A little early. Should have sped up.
That's all right.
I think you need to be within 10 seconds. So yeah, we might be pretty close. In reality, I don't think the game really cares, but
it's all right.
Look at that, within a couple seconds here.
8-7. Commencing. State 4.8. Altimeter 30.04.
See the carrier yet? It's all right. Must be cloudy out. Carriers in sight. Get the little amber light right in front of me.
Altitude.
There's 5,000 feet. Is it platform?
387. Platform.
And go to 2,000 feet.
387.
Center rate.
Roger.
Yeah, I don't know if you can see it. A little amber light right there. That's the carrier.
Alright, coming up on 1,200 feet. 13.8 miles. Alright, let's dirty up the bird. Got a little bit of wind going on. It's blowing me around. It's alright. To the glide slope.
got the gamma so high you can really see that carrier well, huh? It's pretty cool. Oh joy. Dang it. Alright, well this is getting pretty long already. I'm gonna go ahead and hit pause here and try to get this thing out of the boat, and I'll see you in the debrief, alright? Alright, welcome back. So we are in debrief. And man, I hate missing a case 3 recovery. I just was coming in a little shallow and then I powered up, so I started floating a little bit. Anyways, so look at this. 76 aircraft destroyed and 16 ground units lost in the objective area. Ouch. So let's see what the damage is. Oh gosh. And oh, ouch. Dang. We lost 21, 23 aircraft. That is no bueno. 21 aircraft, and they lost, well, they didn't do so well themselves, 53. So they lost 53 aircraft. Holy moly. So this is going to be definitely a war of attrition. Thank God we're up to almost $1 billion per turn. Okay, it looks like two, let me hit OK. And two ships were taken down there, so that's outstanding. Looks like that Moscow remains, and then they also have a couple more smaller ships as well, but I think this Moscow probably should be taken out this next round. Okay, well, with that, let's go ahead and shut this down. Again, always thank you for joining, and I hope you had fun. That gamma was pretty high, and I know these night missions can be a little tough. So, all right. Well, you take care. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.